Hi, I'm Malachi, pastor and founder of Life's Word Ministry, along with my beautiful wife, Christine. Welcome to our podcast. We hope that what you hear will enrich, enhance, and encourage your life in a very special way. It is our endeavor to share a word with you that will help you to live, hope, and change. And now, here's today's podcast. I really think I can start this show out by saying, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I wouldn't be here right now. And there's another one that says, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, what does it say? My soul cries out, hallelujah. Now that's a show starter right there. Because all that I've gone through, if it had not been for the Lord, I wouldn't be here. Think about it, y'all. If it had not been for the Lord, where would you be? All of us can testify to the fact that if God would not have intervened, our situation would be a lot worse than it is right now. There's so many times that we have gotten ourselves into trouble. Nobody else could have helped us. Nobody else could have come to our rescue but God. I have a cousin in Las Vegas that's a gospel rapper, and he goes by the name of IC Jones. That's the letter I, the letter C, J-O-N-E-Z. IC Jones. Look him up. I think you'll enjoy. If you like gospel rap, oh, you're really gonna like this ministry. And his branding is But God. And I know for a fact that it's been God that has helped me, that has rescued me. Many of you can testify to the same thing. But God. Oh, he's good. I know he's good. We got a brief show for you tonight. I don't want to get too riled up because I'm feeling it, y'all, because of all that God has brought me out of. I'm thankful. I'm so thankful. And when we come back, we're going to talk about I'm still here. Why? Because I'm an overcomer. That's why we're still here, ladies and gentlemen, because God has allowed us to endure hardship as a good soldier, and he's helped us, he's rescued us, he's delivered us, he's healed us. I know you feel me. We'll be back right after this. We're gone, yeah. Turns out that I was wrong, cause this is my comeback song, yeah. And by the grace of God, I'm still here. Welcome back to LWM Podcast. I'm your host, Pastor Malachi. You know, I think I'm going to do a name change. You guys let me know what you think of this. Instead of LWM Podcast, we'll change it to Life's Word Podcast. Because it's all about God's Word. And when you get God's Word in your heart, it brings life. Think about it. I'm going to pray about it, mull it over a little bit, talk to some people, some partners of mine, and see about changing our name from LWM Podcast to Life's Word Podcast. Because you know LWM is Life's Word Ministry. And when we talk about his word, it brings life. We started the show off letting you know that it's been God that has been on our side, that has rescued us, that's brought us this far. Because I know without a shadow of a doubt that just as I've been through some difficult times in my life, many of you listening can say amen, that you as well have experienced some situations in your life that you did not know how you were going to come out of it, but you did. That's why I say, as my cousin's branding says, but God. Even now, as I sit here in the studio, thinking of all the times God has rescued me from my own failings, I can't help but to get teary-eyed and to thank God for what he's done for me. I don't understand how people can go through life, through all the situations that they've allowed themselves to get in, and God has helped them out. They don't give God any praise. They don't give him any thanks. They just think it's their own doing, and it's not. And I can't help but to shout out, I'm still here. You're still here. We're still here when all bets were against us to succeed. Those that said we would never amount to anything because of who we were and what we may have done, people have counted us out. But we're still here. We're still going on. When I think about those that have gone on before me, setting the pace for others to follow their lead, they were overcomers. And we too can be overcomers. There's nothing we can't do without God's help to be an overcomer. You have to still be here. After all the headaches and pain, you're still here. After everyone thought you were on your way out, you're still here. Everyone you thought was on your side counted you out. You're still here. Disappointment after disappointment after disappointment, you're still here. Why? Because you're an overcomer. That's why you're still here. When we hear about being an overcomer, the Bible has a lot to say about it, especially in the book of Revelation. The term overcomer is very prominent, where Jesus is encouraging his people to remain steadfast through times of trials. Revelation 2:26 says, "And he who overcomes and keeps my works until the end, to him I will give power over the nations." God will give you power, but you got to trust in him. You got to lean on him. Revelation 3:21 says, "To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne, as I also overcame and sat down with my Father on his throne." Don't tell me that Jesus didn't get up from the grave. He just said, as he overcame death, and he's sitting at the right hand of his Father. Revelation 21:7 says, "He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son." When you overcome, that's when the rewards come. But you have to go through. You have to endure. 1 John 5:4-5 says, "For whatever is born of God overcomes the world." If you are born of God, you've already overcome the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith. Who is the one who overcomes the world? But he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. See, it starts right there. Starts with your faith. Starts with what you believe in. How does one become an overcomer? I'm glad you asked. One becomes an overcomer by, one, being a follower of Christ, and two, who successfully resists the power of this world's system and all of its temptations. How many of you know that the world is full of temptations? Everywhere you turn, there's temptations. Being an overcomer does not mean you're sinless. Oh, no, no, no. But it means that you hold fast to the faith in Christ until the end. Can you hold out? Can you stand firm until the end? You're one that do not turn away when times get difficult or become an apostate, one who renounces their religious beliefs. Overcoming requires a complete dependence upon God for clarity, for direction, for purpose, for fulfillment, and for the strength to follow his plan for our lives. Proverbs 3, 5 and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. My mother used to quote this all the time. In all your ways acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. You have to have trust in the Lord. You got to lean on him, not on your own understanding. That's where we get in trouble, because we want to lean to our own understanding. In all of our ways, we have to acknowledge God, because it's he who directs our path. 2 Corinthians 12:9 says, and he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. You weak? Don't worry about it. He says, my strength is made perfect in your weakness. God's grace is sufficient for you. According to Strong's Concordance, the Greek word most often translated for overcomer stems from the word Nike. It means to carry off the victory. The verb implies a battle. No wonder Nike uses that word for their business. Nike. It means to carry off the victory. Somebody had to look that word up in the Greek. You think Nike just came up? Oh yeah, let's just name our company Nike. No, there's a strong meaning behind the word to carry off the victory. We are taught throughout the Bible to recognize that this world is a battlefield. It's not a playground. And God does not leave us defenseless. There's an armor that is described in Ephesians 6, 11 through 17. We know that very well. And it is an armor of the Lord that is available to all believers. The ammunition to stand firm is scattered throughout this narrative. Just in case you're unaware what the armor of God is, let me read it for you. Ephesians 6, starting at the 10th verse, he says, finally what? After all that I've told you in the previous scriptures, he says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all, to stand. This is my favorite. My mom used to quote this one too. Stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, he says, taking the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. And as for me, that utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mysteries of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that in it I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. Sometimes all it takes to overcome the temptations of this world system is to stand firm and to refuse to be manipulated and dragged into it. James 4 and 7 was very deliberate when he said, resist the devil and he will flee from you. An overcomer is one who resists sin, no matter what allurements the devil uses. The armor God gives us is only for the protection of a frontal attack, not for retreating. He's given you all that you need to protect your front. You can't be an overcomer by running from the enemy. You have to stand your ground and defend the righteousness of God's word. In Romans 8:35 through 39, the Apostle Paul eloquently wrote of overcoming as he summarizes the true power believers have through the Holy Spirit to overcome any attack the enemy will use against us. And in verse 37, it says, in all things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. You're still here because you're an overcomer, because you overcame all that the enemy used to try to take you out. You're still here because through the power of the Holy Spirit helping you to endure the hardness of all of your trials as a good soldier. Enduring is equated with overcoming. Jesus encourages those who follow him to endure to the end. Matthew 28:13. A true disciple of Christ is one who endures through trials by the power of the Holy Spirit, no matter what the cost of discipleship. An overcomer holds fast to Christ until the end. Hebrews 3:14 says, we have come to share in Christ, if indeed we hold our original conviction firmly to the very end. You got to hold on to your conviction, ladies and gentlemen, to the very end. Doesn't matter what you go through. Doesn't matter what you're dealing with. You have to hold on. The book of Revelation, Jesus promised great rewards to those who overcome. Overcomers are promised that they will what? Eat from the tree of life. Revelation 2:7. They're promised that they will be unharmed by the second death. Revelation 2:11. Overcomers are promised that they will eat from the hidden manna and be given a new name. Revelation 2:17. Overcomers are promised that they will have authority over the nations. Revelation 2:26. Overcomers are promised that they will be clothed in white garments. Revelation 3:5. Overcomers are promised that they will be made a permanent pillar in the house of God. Revelation 3:12. And overcomers are promised that they will sit with Jesus on his throne. Revelation 3:21. Holding fast to Jesus is not always easy. Jesus even warned that holding fast to him would not be easy, but it is assured it would be well worth it in the end. In Mark 13:13, he says, you will be hated by all for my name's sake, but the one who endures to the end will be saved. If we are his, we will be able to endure to the end, and his rewards will make it all worthwhile. We have that guarantee in Jesus, ladies and gentlemen. We have that guarantee. You're still here because it's God's purpose for you to be here. Doesn't matter what you've gone through. Doesn't matter what you go through. You can endure to the end if you have faith in God. Let me pray with you. Let me pray that those of you that are not one of his become one of his today. How do you become one of his? By saying yes to Jesus. And if you are ready to fight and put on God's armor, then pray this prayer. Heavenly Father, I come to you admitting that I am a sinner in need of rescuing. Right now, I choose to turn away from my sin, and I ask you to cleanse me of all unrighteousness. I desire to be set free right now, and I ask you to forgive me. I believe that your son, Jesus, died on the cross to take away my sins. I also believe that he rose again from the dead so that I might be forgiven of my sins and made righteous through faith in him. I call upon the name of Christ Jesus and confess him to be my Lord and Savior of my life. Jesus, I choose to follow you, and I ask you to fill me with the power of the Holy Spirit. I declare that right now I am a child of God. I believe that you've heard my prayer, and I believe that you've forgiven me. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me, as declared in Galatians 2:20. I am free from sin and full of the righteousness of God. And I believe that right now I am saved in Jesus' name. Amen. If you prayed this prayer to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior, I welcome you to the family of God. And from this moment on, start learning how to live a life of faith by finding a good Holy Spirit-filled Bible-taught church so that you can grow in your faith as you walk the pathway of Christ. Write to me and share your story of faith. Let me know that you said yes to Jesus. You can email me at lifewordministry@gmail.com. I would also like to take this time to say thank you to those of you that are partnering with us by sowing a financial seed into this ministry regularly. Because of your generous giving, it allows us to share the gospel throughout the world. And if you're not a partner and would like to sow a seed into this ministry, you can do so by going to paypal.me/Life's Word Ministry. Again, that's paypal.me/Life's Word Ministry. And to receive a copy of my brand new book entitled Pathway to Christ, you can go to Amazon and purchase it there. Or if you would like a personally autographed copy, you can go to paypal.me/Malachi 6:60/12 and make your purchase there. What'll happen? You'll be put on a list and I will be signing those books and sending those out, and we'll even pay the postage for you. And be sure to subscribe and follow us right here on LWM Podcast each week. And remember, God loves you and I do too. This concludes our podcast for today. Through one podcast at a time, we are helping you to rise up and overcome many of the world's perplexing problems. Remember to love God, love yourself, and love others. Thank you for subscribing and sharing our podcast with others. Until next time, I'm Pastor Malachi.